Welcome to KMOV TV, CBS in St. Louis. We're the community's news and information leaders with the most consistent and proven journalists in town.
Live downtown, Courtney Bryant, News 4.
Outstanding CBS Prime.
You are awesome. My team and I are going to save you.
Boom.
The best local programming, sports, and a station-wide commitment to imagine a better St. Louis. The stable, consistent, award-winning journalism from KMOV News continues to lead the market, and viewers tune in for our community-focused journalism. There's been a big shift in viewing habits over the last few years, and we're honored that so many St. Louisans rely on KMOV News for the latest information, news, weather, and sports. The excitement for growing viewership in all newscasts is building, along with our increased audience. KMOV Digital continues to grow year over year. In 2016, KMOV Digital will reach over 1 million people each month, or one out of three adults in St. Louis. KMOV.com continues to lead the way with the most up-to-date news, weather, and sports in the market. KMOV Digital also leads the mobile space with five unique mobile news apps, all four-star rated in the app stores. Our KMOV apps have over 1 million downloads to date. KMOV Digital platforms drive local audience engagement with over 300 million page views across desktop and mobile. KMOV's social reach has grown 23% on Facebook and 55% on Twitter in 2016. America's most watched network with television's top shows. The number one comedy. The number one drama. The number one news program. The number one daytime show. And America's number one daytime drama. This is CBS. Number one new comedy, Life in Pieces. First in adults 18 to 49 and 25 to 54. Late Show, the smartest show in late night. James Corden, over 1 billion YouTube views. America's most watched network. And this fall, the hottest new hits are right here. America's most watched network.
God, you're a legend. I can't believe you're here.
You're supposed to be on my side.
I may be the only one who is.
I know everything that goes on in this family.
Can we get a puppy?
Sure.
No.
No.
We will find a way to save you and your baby.
You've given us hope.
The crown goes wide.
Plus, the biggest live events on television. And of course, nobody does it better than CBS Sports. From the best in primetime, the biggest events, to news and sports, it's only CBS.
Brandon Peters, son of tech billionaire Pete Peters, is being arraigned on murder charges.
The accused of the murder of Alyssa Yang was last seen alive on a yacht, her body washed ashore.
My client will be vindicated.
Our system says a man is innocent until proven guilty.
Rich people don't play by the same rules.
If the cops arrest you,
your America is not my America.
The client's here.
Tell me he didn't bring his lawyer.
His five lawyers.
I hate lawyers.
Pete Peters.
Dr. Jason Bull.
Can you help my son?
Absolutely. The jury starts with a preconceived idea of the truth. We don't guess at that.
Dr. Bull profiles every juror, their behavioral patterns, what they click on, likes, avoidances. Then we create a mirror jury and run mock trials. It all gets plugged into a matrix that is scary in its predictive efficiency. Dr. Bull knows how they'll vote even before they do.
I don't want to see this army of lawyers again. Just you and her.
They think you're a rich jerk. He's your jerk son who got everything handed to him.
It's not a popularity contest.
Good, because they don't like you either.
You can't control a trial like this.
You can't.
Do what he says.
Rule number one, the client is the enemy.
Your clothes, your hair, glasses, it's all a code.
They're not going to convict me because of my haircut.
Do you see that? He smirked. He's a smirker.
93% of all communication is nonverbal. You've been testifying since day one. This case could come down to one juror who takes control of the jury.
Tell me about her.
Bess Johnson, 43, divorced. A son, AJ, gay, 24. She has a bumper sticker that says the system is rigged.
Wow, that's cynical.
How do you know it's her?
How do you not know?
You're a con man. That's what you haven't conned me.
I love you, man.
You stole his Rolex.
Do you want us to bug his watch?
I hate surprises. Did you kill Alyssa?
No.
I don't know if you're lying about what happened on that boat, but I do know you're lying about something.
You're supposed to be on my side.
I may be the only one who is.
Ms. Yang, did you know your daughter was a drug dealer?
I just don't like this lawyer.
Misogynistic jerk.
Somebody needs to stick it to this.
I'm so hungover.
We're losing. We've got 2 votes.
We need 10 more votes?
We need 1 vote. 1 juror who takes control of the jury. These people are all linked to Bess.
We still don't have her.
Her son, AJ, went through life looking for the father he never had. Just like Brandon went through life looking for the father he never had.
When Bess sees Brandon, she sees her son, AJ.
Bess's second chance to save her son through Brandon.
My dad says I don't have to testify.
Now is not the time to bail on yourself just because Daddy is. I know Brandon. I've known for a long time.
How did you know? I didn't even know.
Isn't that where you were the night Alyssa was murdered? Look in the mirror and be the man your father never was. You can do this.
They're not gonna believe me.
Don't give up on people. They're all we've got.
You were right. Brandon was hiding something.
Where'd you get this?
There were other girls on the yacht.
How do I get invited to a high school party? Kidding.
Can you read this text message you sent Alyssa?
Keep your hands off Brandon's mind.
You killed Alyssa.
Didn't see that coming. I hate lawyers.
How do you think that makes me feel?
Lawyers like him, Benny. The women on this jury, they hate your boss. Clyde's not doing the direct, you are.
Did you have sex with Alyssa Yang that night?
No.
Why not?
Quiet, please.
On the charge of murder in the second degree, we find the defendant not guilty.
Dr. Bull. Mr. Wolf.
Dr. Bull. You lost this at my office.
Thank you.
Almost looks like a real Rolex.
The president gave me this watch.
Nixon?
Hey, there you are. Since it's your retirement party tonight, if the leaves in the front yard got raked up today, that'd be great.
Oh, that'd be unbelievable.
I mean, you're home now. You have nothing but free time.
But that's the misconception about retired people. Some of us are very active, like me. I got the guys coming over at 11 for a little day drinking. Then we're all going to learn how to use crossbows.
Dad, I probably shouldn't go to school today. I think I got a concussion from football.
Jack, you play Madden football.
I have a little cake made up for you.
Oh.
This is your husband's first homicide scene.
Oh. Well, his little head fell off.
Oh, no. That's where it ended up.
Now, Thursday, we got our go-kart race, and on Friday, we got shooting paintballs. I say we combine them. We call it, like, paint cart or go-balls.
Yeah, I'm not down with go-balls.
Oh!
There's my baby girl. Look at this. I thought you had midterms.
Hey, grab plates. There's burgers in there for all of us.
Actually, there's only 4. All right, fine. You guys can split one.
You didn't tell him, did you? About your boyfriend? No, you told me not to.
Hey, guys, quick update. I'm already 2 burgers in, and there's really no sign of me slowing down, so I think we're going to have to rethink the burger fractions.
We don't have time to eat anyway.
Oh, thank God, because I ate all of them.
We got charged $90 for 4 tubs of muscle milk protein powder.
Oh, that was me. I was watching Rocky 3, and I got all fired up. And then I'll return it.
I got you a little retirement gift. It's a gyro ball.
Oh, I know what it is, Donna. It's the bowl that won't spill. How did you know I wanted it?
Every time the commercial came on, you kicked out your legs and you screamed.
Yeah, and it worked because now I have one. Let's test this baby out. We're going to catch it.
Okay.
All right, here
right,
we go.
Great.
Ready? Now give me a scenario where I might spill it.
You're on a fishing boat.
Oh.
Having a snack.
I like that.
Yeah.
Oh, look, okay. Look at that. Ooh. Oh, look at that.
Yeah, but the water's choppy.
Oh, is it choppy?
No, it's choppier than that.
Oh.
Yeah. Now you give me a scenario.
Okay, now you are a prostitute. You... Well, I'm sorry, I don't even know where that came from.
Hey, I'm Todd.
Oh, I'm Chael.
I have a lot of cops in my family, so much respect, sir.
Thanks, Todd. So you boys pretty low with Kendra?
I am, but I also play baseball.
And Chael got his degree in computer science. He's working on this amazing app.
You may be coming to my retirement party next year.
You know, I played some ball myself. I was
no.
a pitcher, yeah.
What?
I actually hit 90 once on the gun.
Oh, my God, that's a nice heat.
Hey,
it was one time.
Hey, Dad, I need to tell you something.
Relax. I know I've been tough on your boyfriends before, but I like this one. Todd's a winner.
It's not Todd. It's Chael.
Who's Chael?
I'm Chael.
We're in love. It'll be a year in October.
You knew about this?
Thank you for sticking to the plan, honey. I had to do something. Dad was falling for Todd.
Of course I was. He's awesome. But Chael, nothing. No sparks.
Guys, he wants to change the world.
Well, you know what? I want to go on tour with Taylor Swift, but I don't know her, and I don't play guitar.
And in your mind, those are the only things holding you back?
We're engaged. Engaged?
What?
Chael and I have a plan. I'm dropping out of school to support Chael until he makes it big.
Okay.
Honey, that's not a plan. That is literally every stripper's backstory.
Right now, we just need to focus on Kendra.
Yeah, she's going back to school. That's it.
Agreed.
And she's not marrying that guy. He's a loser. He's a bore fest. And he doesn't deserve my daughter.
Whoa.
What?
I just heard my father's voice. That's exactly what he said about you.
I know, everybody heard the toast. You always make great decisions. Why are you doing this?
Jeff, you always told me to find someone who respects me and makes me feel special.
I think we get all that with Todd.
Jeff, why can't you give Chael a chance? You made a pretty bad first impression. He's sensitive.
All right, if you promise to go to school down here, you and Chael can... move into the house, all right? I won't rent the garage.
I thought you needed that for your retirement.
We'll figure something out, all right? Come on, I love you.
Right. Oh, thank you, Dad.
But I know you think your retirement is screwed up.
No, I had 2 days. It was a good run.
You do get to spend a lot more time with your kids, and at the end of the day, isn't that ultimately better?
3, 2, 1!
Dad, my seat's wobbly.
You get separated, just meet back at the house, all right? You're gonna be good. Go! Oh! Yeah, baby!
Kevin Can Wait. New comedy coming to CBS this fall.
I'm going back to work.
Yay!
Daddy's in charge now.
Fatherhood.
That's right.
I love you, Daddy.
Oh, you guys, we're gonna have so much fun.
Can we get a puppy?
Sure.
No.
No.
I'm hungry and thirsty.
Me too.
I don't have anything.
What? I've literally never been thirstier.
Mommy had snacks and ice-cold waters every day.
Hey, easy. It's me, Daddy Fun Times. Here, have a Listerine strip.
Daddy?
Yeah, Butterbean?
I'm worried about kindergarten.
Honey. You should be worried. Kids are mean. But just know, if you ever feel uncomfortable, you start swinging, okay? Punching the nose can be a real problem solver.
I'd like to welcome you all to the kindergarten parent mingle. Has anyone seen Mrs. Burns?
I'm Mr. Burns.
Mr. Burns, your wife graciously volunteered to be our room parent, so there's just a few things.
She's not gonna be able to do that. See, she's decided to go back to work.
Oh, okay. So I'll just pencil you in.
Whoa. Hey, I'd love to, but please stop writing my name down.
What a wonderful group. I can't wait to meet each and every one of you. Mr. Burns, I'd like to see you after the mingle.
Just think of the children. There's not a thing I wouldn't do for them, and I know you feel the same way.
No.
Come at him.
Lol. I'm a stay-at-home dad. 4 years now, it hasn't changed me at all. Oh, you got a little something.
Hey. I'm gonna say it has changed you.
I just can't believe they're not introducing any foreign language in kindergarten. How can our children compete in a global economy without fluency in a second language?
You know this school is free, right? Free stuff is not that great. Water is free, but beer, you gotta pay for.
Yeah. Beer. It's so great to connect on a masculine level again.
Where are the regular moms? Everybody line up.
What?
Line up. 1, 2, 3. I can't believe I have to explain a line to you. Why did you just dump all your stuff everywhere?
We always do.
Well, who cleans it up?
I don't know.
Okay, well, from now on, you're gonna hang your backpacks up, and you're gonna clean up the truck before you get out and close the door. That's right. They're not the same kids I used to see when I got home at night. Those kids smelled good and were delightful. I'm Daddy Fun Times. I'm like Johnny Cash. I fly in, I play the prison, everybody loves me. And then I'm out of there. I don't want to be the warden. I need help. I can't believe I'm about to say this, but Lowell, what do you think I should do?
I managed to get my girls addicted to lottery scratchers, and I simply withhold them when they don't do what I say.
Well, first of all, good luck with your future exotic dancers. Plus, I don't have time to get my kids addicted to something and then take it away. I need a solution now.
Oh my God, my iPad is at 1%. What do I do? Kill your apps. Dad, give me your phone. I just need a little something to get me to the house.
Relax. It's like you guys are addicted to those. My little junkies. And panic.
Can't get online. Nothing works. What's happening? Is it the Wi-Fi? Is the Wi-Fi out?
Every day, the password will change. And until your chores get done, you won't get your fix.
At least ease us in. Maybe today is just explaining it, and then tomorrow...
I know you're mad at me, but you know what? That's okay. Because I'm not your friend. I'm your father. My chores are done, so I have the password. If you'll excuse me, I have candy to crush.
So quiet.
I outwitted them, like the Roadrunner.
This might be the most attractive you've ever been.
I agree.
I'm finding myself very drawn to your alpha male energy.
Don't say stuff like that, Lowell. It's weird.
Such an alpha.
That's me. James Bell. When I became a tech billionaire, it gave me a chance to change the world. So, I built the most revolutionary medical center on Earth, right here in Silicon Valley.
If you place your thumb on the tablet, I can give you full access to the hospital.
Dr. Wallace, welcome to the revolution. This is the wall. It's mission control for every patient. CT scans, MRI, anything that you need to know or the patient wants to know is available at any time. And when it's not medical, the patient gets to choose where they want to be. Rising over the moon. Studies show that patients sleep better. They have better recoveries if they feel more control over their environment. Mr. and Mrs. Beyer, welcome to Bunker Hill.
You've given us hope. Because of your pregnancy, you chose not to have chemotherapy. At the rate your cancer is growing, we don't have weeks to act. We have days.
If we wait until the fetus is viable, it will be too late.
For our baby?
For both of you. I didn't build this hospital to deliver bad news, so we will find a way to save both you and your baby.
I appreciate what you're trying to do here, but I have to be honest, gadgets and gizmos have been around the medical industry forever. Medicine is ultimately a human endeavor.
Good speech, W. Let me show you why you're dead wrong. This is the E-Hub.
Malik,
show him. You show him. It's an adhesive computer. Monitors everything about you.
How long did it take you to get this program up and running?
8 months ago?
Yeah.
No red tape, doctor. We're pairing the most brilliant minds in medicine with the most brilliant minds in technology. We're gonna get stuff done. This is the revolution, Dr. Wallace.
So, do you think it's possible what James is trying to do?
About 90% of the time that I'm here, I think this can never work. But that leaves a 10% chance that we're actually going to be able to be a beacon for change.
This is Lewis Keating. He's been diagnosed with GSS, Gerstmann-Strasser-Shanker disease.
It's a neurological disease. It's like ALS on steroids.
Also extremely rare.
200 cases worldwide.
Yeah, I have to agree. This case is extremely esoteric.
This is a fascinating disease. I want this patient.
There's only been one case of GSS in the Bay Area in the last 50 years. She had a child she gave up for adoption, August 28th, 1985. Your birthday. If I'm gonna even think about uprooting my life to come here, I need to know why you're here. Why we're all here. Are we here to save the world? Or are we all here to save James Bell?
How is she doing today?
I think it's time to talk to her parents about taking her off life support. It has been 6 months.
Promise her parents? What am I supposed to say to them?
We can't make those kinds of promises.
We know you won't give up on her, James.
Please don't do that.
You're tense.
That's making me tenser. New scan of Margo's heart. There's only one way to remove the tumor, and a million ways it could go wrong.
What if I could give you a million chances to get it right? And we can print as many as you need. Put up here, Elliot. Come on. Come to Papa.
Okay, everybody, just gather around. I got something to say. Our coma patient. We've been trying to get her to come out to us. I've decided we're gonna stop trying to get her to come to us. We're gonna go to her. Go right to the cerebral cortex. And I thought, well, that's impossible. And then I found this. Brain-to-brain communication.
But it says here that this kind of technology won't be available to the masses for another decade.
Do I look like the masses? They needed funding. We now own this. We're gonna use it to find out unequivocally whether Chrissy is still Chrissy. Because then we know whether there's someone still there to save. And
you ready?
Yes.
I want you to focus your thoughts on the images that come up on the wall.
She loves animals. We were planning to go on a safari together.
Oh my God.
The reds and yellows in her cerebral cortex, it all indicates brain activity, consciousness.
Chrissy, it's Dad.
Hi, Daddy.
I should tell you, I did have the genetic test done, and it came back positive for GSS. Over the next 5 years, the man that everybody calls a genius won't be able to remember his own name.
I'm so sorry, James.
I built the hospital for all the wrong reasons, but does that really matter?
I want to be part of this.
James, your new transfer arrived. GSS patient.
Mr. Keating. Welcome to Bunker Hill.
Excuse me, ID please.
ID? That's cute. I'm Jack Gordon. That's my ID right there. Oh, hey, is that one of those special dogs that weird people can take anywhere?
You're not allowed to ask if it's an emotional support animal.
I think I have my answer. Jack Gordon, it is so incredible to meet you. I'm Clark, online content curator.
Hi, Clark. Obviously made up job title.
Guys, this is the Jack Gordon. Jack, this is our social influencer, Emma.
Oh my God, you're a legend. I can't believe you're here. Good news, we just had our most retweeted online poll. Best outdoor gear for the zombie apocalypse.
Yeah, nailed it! Can you guess the number one zombie killing tool?
Remembering zombies don't exist? I'm gonna go see the guy who runs the Real magazine. I'll think of you on my flight to Patagonia.
Not as smart as he thinks. Patagonia's like 3 blocks away.
Sorry to have pulled you out of the wild.
Look, I need you here desperately. You're the voice of the magazine. Those young kids, they're smart, yes, but they don't know what to write about.
Yeah, I've seen the website. Best 3 ways to drink your own urine? There is no best way.
You just drink it.
Why don't you start by telling these guys what the magazine means to you?
Well, I think it's about getting out of your house, out of the city, out of your ruts.
Maybe we should change the name of the magazine to Out.
Well, Out is already a gay magazine.
You're not allowed to say that anymore.
No, it's an actual gay magazine. Ask Mason.
why me? Are you saying I'm gay, Jack?
I don't, just bandana.
Just messing with you, man. No.
We need some digital tie-ins to your piece on the bears. Name one thing to do if a bear attacks.
Die. You die.
You can't keep doing this lone wolf thing forever.
I'm not gonna change, and I'm fine with that.
Oh, really? Well, that's not what you told me that night at the retreat.
Yeah, well, we said a lot of things that night we didn't mean. Like, this is my last mojito. I'm gonna go back to my room. Don't use that. That's been in your wallet for years.
Mr. Gordon, do you realize why this meeting has been called between you and human resources? Young adults today are a very delicate group. We offer an entire class on how to deal with that.
Oh, is the class called I Was Born in the 90s, Wah?
Behold your new assignment.
Jack, hey, look, I tied my own knot.
You're all so confident. I mean, you went to good schools. You played on winning teams.
We only won 2 games that year.
You're holding a huge trophy.
Yeah, we got that because we all tried really hard.
Yeah, well, so did the team that won. Trophies are for winners.
Ew.
I know you guys always have to have fun at work, so I thought I'd bring you some of the real world that I keep talking about. And his species has had quite a bit of trouble recently, but with a little bit of help, he's gonna learn how to adapt.
Wow, you know, in a way, that's a lot like what's happening.
You draw a parallel right now, I will tear both your arms off and beat you with them.
Mr. Gordon, do you realize why we're here again?
I brought a bear into the office.
And?
And it ate Esther's support animal.
I just found these bears playing in someone's swimming pool. That's pretty cool.
This is not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about a majestic species on the brink of extinction. You guys don't know what it's like to look at a creature that is the last of its kind.
Yeah, we do.
Oh, I enjoyed that more than I thought I would.
Me too.
KMOV is much more than just CBS. Our local programming extends to Prime specials, news specials, and our daily lifestyle show, Great Day St. Louis.
Good morning, and welcome to Great Day St. Louis. Matt will be back tomorrow. And good morning to all of you fancy people like this guy.
Well, I do consider myself to be pretty fancy.
You are so fancy.
Plus, Steve Templeton's four-degree guarantee has generated more than $32,000 in donations to date for our partners. More importantly, KMOV has raised awareness for each organization. And we don't stay in the studio. KMOV goes out to the community all year. With signature events like the Cardinals opening day celebration, broadcasting the city's biggest parades, the Storm Team Tour, Great Day on the Road, and Traverse for Schools. We believe in reaching out to our audience and making a very personal connection. Beginning in 2015, KMOV committed itself to being a positive force in the community. Under the umbrella of the campaign, Imagine a Better St. Louis, we've partnered with Habitat for Humanity to build affordable housing. With Better Family Life, we've supported a boots-on-the-ground effort to end violence and give communities a renewed sense of hope. And News 4 features positive, inspirational stories of people helping to make St. Louis great.
Good to see you guys.
Yes, sir.
All right. All right.
KMOV TV, on the grow with news, CBS Prime, local programming and sports, and much, much more. We're honored to be watching out for you and are looking forward to continuing how we serve you.